Good morning, students. Today we will study chapter number 8, Python Basics. In this chapter, you will be learning the basics of the programming language Python. What are the features of Python? Then what are the benefits of Python over other programming language? And then what's the history of Python and why do we use Python? Apart from this, we will also learn how to get started by programming in Python. We'll be writing simple programs in Python and we'll see how it works. Now let us start with what is Python. Python is a general purpose, high level, interpreted, dynamic type language. Now we have seen all these terminologies. Now let us understand them one by one. So what is general purpose? A language which is designed to use for writing softwares in various application domain without being restricted to a particular domain is a general purpose language. For example, it is not restricted to one particular domain, like Python is used only for web applications or it is used only for gaming application. Python can be used in multiple domains like machine learning, or it may be used for automated systems, it may be used for gamings, it may be used for web applications on server sites. So that's what a general purpose language is about. Then high level language. Because Python uses the general English and the mathematical terms, so that is why it's a high level language and very easy to understand. Then Python is interpreted language. Interpreted language is the one which need a separate compiler interpreter to translate its bytecode. When you enter the code in Python, you need a separate translator program to convert that Python code into the bytecode. Next, it is a dynamically typed language. Being dynamically typed means that the Python parser automatically infers or identifies the type of variable on the basis of what kind of data you have assigned to the variable. Let's say when we talk about variable in mathematics, so when you talk about variable, variables are the values which keep changing. So the values which are not fixed are variables. Whenever you enter these values into the variable, automatically Python parser will understand what type of value you have entered, and accordingly it will decide the type of variable it is. For example, if you are entering a numerical as the variable, as the value of the variable, let's say you have taken a variable called a, and now in a if you enter the value as 1, and when you print a, so because you have taken the value of a as 1, now the type of data you have entered is a numerical type, so it may take its data type as integer. Now in the second type, I enter a is equals to hello. So hello is a word which I am giving to the value of a, whereas previously I have given a number as the value. So this time around when I try to print a, it is not going to show me an error because of the dynamical nature of Python. So because it is a dynamically typed language, it will automatically look for the value which I have entered in a, and it will automatically consider the data type of that particular variable. So this is what is dynamically typed language is. So the general definition of Python becomes: Python is a general purpose, high level, interpreted, dynamically typed programming language. Now children, let us see the history of the programming language Python. It was initially designed by Guido van Rossum in 1991, and it was developed by Python Software Foundation. It was mainly developed for emphasis on code readability, and its syntax allows programmer to express concept in fewer lines of code. Let's dig deeper into the concept and see how the invention of this programming language has taken place. In the late 1980s, history was about to be written when the working on this programming language started. Van Rossum began doing its application-based work in December 1989 at CWI, which is situated in Netherlands. It was started firstly as a hobby project because he was looking for something interesting to do. But later on, he used the framework of ABC programming language, which worked on Amoeba operating system. And by removing the errors in that language and making it more efficient, he came up with this new programming language. Now, as he wanted the name of this programming language to be short and mysterious, he named it as Python. Python officially released in the year 1991, and with its release, it became popular compared to the other languages like Java, C++, and C. Python became popular because of its easy design and code readability. Plus, it also gave advanced productivity to the developers. Though there are a number of programming languages present like Ruby, Perl, C, C++, Java, but still Python has got its own importance in the world of programming. Now let us see, why do we use Python? Why Python? There are a number of programming languages you can consider. But then what is so important about Python, or what is so special about Python that you consider it? First thing is, Python is very easy to understand and learn when compared to the other programming language. So if you consider other programming languages, you might write 2 to 3 lines of code for a simple hello world program. But whereas in Python, the task is done with one simple line. We'll see how it is done later on in the video. Then it is free and open source programming language. So the benefit of having free and open source programming language is, you get a lot of support online. Let's say you are writing a program or you are developing an application and you get stuck. Being a free and open source language, there are a number of libraries you can get access to and make your work easy. Then fewer code lines and less time. So as I told you, it's very easy to understand and learn, and implementation is also very easy because for one single output, you don't have to write number of lines of codes like in other programming languages. The next advantage is object-oriented language. Python is an object-oriented language. Now, what is an object-oriented language? There are a number of programming languages we have, procedure-oriented languages, and then there are object-oriented languages. In object-oriented languages, children, your entire program will consist of different objects. Let's say you have a pencil box. In the pencil box, there are different articles which you put. There are different pens, pencil, eraser, sharpener. So all these components, all these individual components, they are different objects of your box. So similarly, when you write the program in Python, all the different elements you're going to enter into the program, they will be considered as different objects. The benefit of having object-oriented language is that its object can be reused in different programs. So for the other programs, you don't have to write the code again. You can use the objects which you have already written for a program. Next one is huge community. Because Python is widely used programming language, there is 24/7 online support you get. Wherever you get stuck, there may be someone out there who can easily help you out with the problem. Now let us see what are the important features of Python that makes it popular. The first feature I have already explained you is the object-oriented programming language. The next feature of Python is cross-platform. It is not fixed that Python belongs to only one platform. Let's say you are using Windows, so you can use Python on Windows. If you are using Linux, you have Python for Linux. If you are using Mac, you can use Python on Mac. So there is no fixed platform that Python belongs to only one platform. This language can be used on multiple platforms, on multiple operating systems. The next one is rich libraries. So in Python, you have number of libraries that support you with your application development, with your automation development, for your programming, for your gaming development. So there is a complete separate library for developing the games in Python. So there are a number of libraries which Python provides you, which makes your work easy and better. The next one is integrable. So Python can be integrated with other programming languages and you can make use of it pretty much ease and comfort with other programming languages as well. For example, you can use Python with Java, you can use Python with PHP, you can use Python with C#, and it goes very well with all these programming languages. The next one is simple to use. As I told you, the code in Python is very easy and understandable, and it's really very simple to use the code and write the code in Python. Now let us see what are the applications of Python. Where do we use Python? The first application of Python is in web applications. So whenever you see the different web applications on the internet, Python is a widely used programming language for these web applications. The web application development of Python is applied on the server side of the machine. The next one is in data analytics. Children, nowadays data analytics has become a major part of the IT industries. There is huge amount of data produced every day from different fields. So all this data has to be analyzed, it has to be arranged properly, and it has to be analyzed properly. And Python is one language which is very effectively used for analysis of data. Then third one is machine learning. Training the machines for automatic learning. For example, you have your iPhone Siri, you have Alexa. So all these are the machine learning algorithms involved with the electronic gadgets, and then these gadgets work in a smart way. They do functions which you order them to do, and this is due to machine learning. And Python is the language which can be easily used to implement the machine learning algorithms. Then in the game development, as I told you, Python has a separate library of its own for developing different games. Automation. So it can be also used in the automated technology. These are the widely used applications of Python which makes Python so important today. Now let us see why is Python better than other programming languages. So there are number of programming languages, as I told you, which can be used for web development, for automation, for games development. How is Python different from these programming languages like Java, C#, PHP, Perl, Ruby? So these are very popular languages, but then why is Python better than them? First thing is the code in Python is smaller and it's convenient to use. Second is it is easy to debug. What is debugging? Finding out the error in the program, finding out the error in the code is called debugging, and it's very easy and simple to debug in Python when compared to any other programming language. This is because of the number of lines of code. So in other programming languages, let's say if you have 3 or 4 lines to print something, in Python this can be done only in a single line. Similarly, Python is mostly based on indentation of your data, how you align your lines of code. So that is the main key feature of Python, which makes it very easy to debug. Then it supports scientific and engineering applications, and it has got better integration with other programming language. Now let us get started with Python. To start off Python, first thing is you need to install Python in your system. So to install Python in your system, you need to download Python from its official website, that is www.python.org/downloads. Now let us see how it is done. In www.python.org/downloads, you have the installation download for Python 3. Simply click on that. You will have options for Python 3 on Windows, Python 3 on Mac, Python 3 on Linux. So whatever operating system you are using, just click on that and download. Once the file is downloaded, you get the .exe file. Now you have to run the .exe file. When you run the .exe file, once the installation is done, you are good to go. How do we check that Python is installed in the computer? So what you will do is just go to start and type Python. When you type Python here, you can see IDLE Python. So you have to click on IDLE. When you click on IDLE, this is how the shell is going to open. Now in this shell, you will write your Python programs. Now let us write one sample program and see if this is working or not. Let's say I want to print hello world because that's my first program. So you have to write print brackets. These are called parentheses. In the parentheses, you will give the inverted commas and write down your text. So I want to print hello world. So I'll write hello world and that's it. Once you are done writing this, just press enter and there you go. You got the output. Whatever is written inside the parentheses will be displayed on the screen as it is. So print hello world is the Python code and hello world in blue color which you see, that is the output. Let us now add two numbers. 2 plus 3, click enter, 5. Similarly, 2 into 7, 14. So this is how simple it is to write the program in Python. So now what I want you all to do is download Python in your computers or laptops and then open IDLE shell and see if you are able to write the simple Python programs like I did now. Later on in the chapter, we will do some more programs related to Python. Till then, you have to install Python in your computers or laptops and practice this program.